Breaking news out of Tuscaloosa, Alabama. Bama Insider announces that Jaleel Skinner has committed with the Alabama Crimson Tide. A tight end out of the class of 2022, Alabama, now lands their second commit in the past week. Andrew Bone here to join me. Andrew, another big commitment for this Crimson Tide class of 2022. Your thoughts and why he decided to choose Alabama?
Well, rich get richer. I mean, this is a unbelievable tight end class for Alabama, you know, to go along with Elijah Brown and also, you know, Martin Niblock, which you can also consider him just an athlete. But what an unbelievable run at tight end position for Alabama in this class. I get Jaleel Skinner, who, you know, reminds me a little bit of another Jaleel Billingsley. So, you know, he's very athletic. You know, this is a guy who, you know, can stretch the field. He's got great speed and, you know, you want to get your ball to your playmakers, and this is a guy that can make big plays. So Alabama fans should be extremely excited about Jaleel. Obviously plays at one of the top high school football programs in the country, originally from Greer High School. Well, from Greer, South Carolina. I did attend Greer High School, but originally from South Carolina. And, you know, obviously had some top schools on his list, Texas, Florida State, Miami, Alabama, Clemson. In the end, Crimson Tide wins.
No doubt about it. Guys, hit that like button and subscribe to the channel. Thank you for joining us for this breaking news update. Now, Skinner, of course, a top recruit in this class of 2022. What does this mean for the tight end class now? Obviously, adding another big commitment. They just keep going. Like you said, the rich keep getting richer.
Yeah, I mean, it's finished now. You know, this is a you know, certainly a guy that they wanted for a long time. Took his official visit back in June. I think it was June the 17th, 18th. It was about that third weekend in June. And, you know, ever since then, Alabama's just, you know, continued to stay in contact with him, continued to recruit him. And even though they had Elijah Brown and Amari Niblock committed, they were still, you know, gung-ho on getting Jaleel Skinner in this year's class. They really liked him a lot, you know, from the beginning. And, you know, I know the staff is extremely excited today about getting Skinner officially on board.
What do you think was that ultimate, you know, factor for him to decide Alabama over those other schools you mentioned a minute ago?
Well, yeah, obviously the consistency, you know, the winning, you know, the offense. Alabama, you know, lost so much on offense last year. They also lost their offensive coordinator, and you know, they're continuing to put up big numbers, especially the tight end position. You watch film on Alabama, or you watch the game, you're seeing Cam Latu, you're seeing Jaleel Billingsley making plays throughout the game. And I think that's something that, you know, really sold Jaleel on Alabama, and obviously sells other kids on Alabama. But, you know, the offense, just the consistency, the high-powered attack, you know, is certainly something that, you know, all these top offensive players want to be a part of. You know, we used to not talk about Alabama like that. We used to talk about defense, you know, smash mouth football. Now it's this high flying offense that all these top, you know, athletes want to be a part of and make big plays and score touchdowns and put up big numbers. And you know, that's something that I think Jaleel Skinner feels like he can do in Tuscaloosa.
The game is certainly changing. Great to have Jaleel Skinner as a part of this tight end group now. Alabama fans never satisfied. They always want to know who is next. Who, in your opinion, do you see committing next?
Oh, that's always a tough question. You know, everybody wants you to be right. And, you know, when kids don't have commitment dates scheduled, it's always kind of tricky, you know, kind of predicting who's going to be that next one to jump on board. But obviously, you know, we've talked about some of these guys for a long time. And, you know, I'm certainly looking at Barrion Brown, wide receiver out of Nashville, who certainly has very high interest in Alabama. Took a visit to Kentucky last weekend, but even though he really enjoyed that trip, I still see him as a part of Alabama's recruiting class in the end. You know, another prospect that I'm watching a little bit more closely than I was maybe a month ago is Curtis Perry, defensive lineman out of Montgomery at Pike Road High School. Perry took a visit to Tuscaloosa last week. Now, he says he's going to have a top five released on October the 15th, but wouldn't be surprised if we saw him drop a top five and then potentially a commitment date along with that. I could see him making a commitment, you know, in the near future, and I think Alabama's in great shape with Curtis Perry. So those are two guys. You know, we've talked about some other guys in the past, like Denver Harris, but I think Denver's probably going to wait a little bit longer in terms of making his decision. You know, a lot of other guys are just, you know, wanting to experience these game day, you know, environments and go on some more visits before making that decision. So we're going to see more commitments happen in November, December, then we probably will in October. Obviously, this is a big commitment today in Jaleel Skinner jumping on board. But yeah, I'm not sure we're going to see many more commitments this month. But obviously, you know, the way the season's going, just getting kids back on campus, you know, they're going to come back for that Tennessee game. You're going to see, you know, a lot of top recruits in Tuscaloosa in early November for that LSU game. That's going to be probably the weekend that a lot of people are going to be focused on. I wouldn't focus too much on who's going to commit Saturday or Sunday. Wait until a week or two later, see who all, you know, potentially jumps on board. But could be a big November for Alabama, you know, heading into that early signing period in December.
Certainly could. Jaleel Skinner, a big part of this October now. And like you said, the world of recruiting was absolutely shaken up, like everything else with the pandemic. Returning to normal now, these commits, recruits, you know, getting back on campus, really getting to experience these schools. Jaleel Skinner added to the class now of 2022. Your final thoughts as Alabama adds another tight end to this class?
Yeah, you know, just a tremendous pickup. You got to give a lot of credit to the Alabama coaching staff, Drew Savoda, the new tight ends coach who's, you know, come in and done a tremendous job, you know, recruiting players, especially at the tight end position. You know, Robert Gillespie, who's in charge of recruiting IMG Academy, you know, done a tremendous job this year as well. So just a big pickup for Alabama, you know, cements himself inside the top five. Can Alabama continue to creep up and potentially get to that number one ranking? I think they're going to have a chance, especially when these updated rankings come out in December. You're going to see some guys in the class that are going to move up, but also, you know, who can Alabama close with over the course of the next few months? That's going to determine who's going to have the number one class in the country.
For the latest recruiting news, guys, go to BamaInsider.com. Check out Andrew Bone's work. You can find him on Twitter as well, at Andrew J. Bone. Alabama lands Jaleel Skinner in the class of 2022. This has been a breaking news update on BamaInsider.com.